Hello students, so today we will see numerical problems on generation time and bacterial growth. So such type of problems, these are very useful for students who are preparing for SLET or SET, NET, JRF in life sciences, as well as those students who are preparing for MSc entrance exams. And on the demand of many students, today I am going to upload this video on such types of problems or numerical problems. So let's start first problem here, and the problem is E. coli cells divides after every 30 minutes. If you inoculate a culture with 200 E. coli cells, how many E. coli cells will be present after 4 hours? So in this problem, they are told that E. coli cell, it is dividing after 30 minutes. And the initial number of E. coli cells which are inoculated, it is 200. We have to calculate total number of E. coli cells after 4 hour duration. So let's start the solution here. So this is the given information, that E. coli cells divides after every 30 minutes. Then N0, that is nothing but initial number of cells, and it is equal to 200 E. coli cells. Then generation time, it is 30 minutes, because that E. coli cell is dividing after every 30 minutes. So that's why that 30 minutes, it is the generation time, or that is nothing but G. Now we have to calculate N, that is number of generations, that we have to calculate. Then second, we have to calculate this capital N, which is nothing but the total number of E. coli cells. So these things we have to calculate here. So now we are having the information that E. coli cell, it is dividing after 30 minutes, and therefore in 4 hours it will divide for how many times? 8 times. It will divide for 8 times, and that's why this 8, it is nothing but the number of generations, which is denoted by small n. So this small n, that is n equal to number of generation, and here the number of generation will be 8. Now therefore, that 2 raised to the power n, n means here number of generation. So, and the value of that n is here 8. So that's why 2 raised to the power 8, it will become 256. So this will become 256. Now we are having this 2 raised to the power n, it is equal to 256. Now we are having the formula, that is total number of E. coli cells after 8 generations, that is after 4 hours, it is equal to 2 raised to the power n into N0. N0 means here initial number of cells. So we will put that values here, 2 raised to the power 8 into 200, because that 200 is the initial number of E. coli cells, which is already given in the problem. Now we are having this 2 raised to the power 8, it is means 256 multiplied by 200, and the final answer will become here 51,200. So this 51,200, it is nothing but the that cells which are formed after 8 generation or after 4 hours. So this is the first problem here, and that's why the answer is, therefore 51,200 E. coli cells will be present after 4 hours of duration. So this is about the first problem here. Just 1 minute, I will erase all this narration, then we will move towards the second numerical problem here. That is same problem, and you will get information when such types of problems will be there. That may be in your NET JRF exams, or that may be your that MSc entrance exams, or your regular BSc or MSc microbiology. So let's start with the second problem here. That is of same type again. See, Bacillus cereus divides every 30 minutes. You inoculate a culture with exactly 100 bacterial cells. After 3 hours, how many Bacillus cereus bacterial will be present in the inoculum? So same type of problem is here. Now this Bacillus cereus, it is dividing after every 30 minutes, and the initial population of this bacteria, it is 100 bacterial cells. Now we have to calculate the total number of Bacillus cereus bacteria after 3 hours. See the given information, Bacillus cereus, it is dividing after every 30 minutes. Then again N0 means here initial number of cells, and that is already given in the problem, and it is equal to 100 cells. Then generation time, that is equal to 30 minutes, because that Bacillus cereus, it is dividing after every 30 minutes. So that's why that 30 minutes, it is the generation time. Now we have to calculate number 1, N equal to, or that N, that is nothing but the number of generation, that we have to calculate here. Then we have to calculate capital N, that is nothing but the total number of Bacillus cereus cells. Again we have to calculate this one also. Now we will see this Bacillus cereus is dividing after every 30 minutes, that is given, and so in 3 hours it will divide for 6 times, because in 30 minutes it is dividing. So that's why in 3 hours that Bacillus cereus, it will divide for how many times? 6 times. So it will divide for 6 times in 3 hours. So it will divide for 6 times in 3 hours, and therefore the number of generations, that is equal to 6. Now again we are having the formula here, that is 2 raised to the power 6. So 2 raised to the power 6, 6 means here it is the value of N. So that 6, it is nothing but the value of N. So 2 raised to the power N means here 2 raised to the power 6, and it will become 64. It will become 64. Now just 1 minute again, I will erase all these things. So 2 raised to the power 6 means it is equal to 64. Now we are having the formula that total number of Bacillus cereus cell, that is N, equal to 2 raised to the power N into initial number of Bacillus cereus cells. So already we have calculated this 2 raised to the power 6, and we are having this initial number of Bacillus cereus, it is equal to 100. So therefore 2 raised to the power 6 into 100, which is equal to 6400. So that's why the final answer will be here, total number of bacillus cereus cells after 3 hours, that is equal to 6400. So this is the final answer of this second problem. That is 6400 bacillus cereus cells will be present after 3 hours. So here we finish this second problem, that is of similar type. Now the next point or next problem we will see here, it is something different. See, the third problem is, if the initial number of bacterial cell is 100 and the final number of bacterial cells is 6400, how many generations will require to this bacterial cell to produce these 6400 cells? So in first and second problem, we have calculated the total number of bacterial cells after particular duration, and whatever that initial cells and final cells are there in that problems, that same values we have taken in this third problem. That is, the initial number of bacterial cells is here 100 and the final number of bacterial cells is 6400. Now from this given information, we have to calculate the number of generations. That is, we have to calculate how many generations are required to this bacterial cell to produce these 6400 cells. So now here we have to calculate the number of generations, and that is nothing but the G. This G we have to calculate, that is number of generations. So we are having this information now, initial number of bacterial cells, that is equal to N0 and it is 100 cells. Then we are having final number of bacterial cells, that is N equal to 6400 cells. So these two values we are having. Now we have to calculate the number of generations, that is N. Now we are having the formula, that is that total, now see that formula we are having, just 1 minute. Now see, we are having this formula here, that is N means number of generations equal to log of N, means here final number of bacterial cells, that is number of generations, it is equal to log of final number of bacterial cells minus log of initial number of bacterial cells divided by log of 2. So this formula we are having, we will put the values in this formula. So N equal to log of 6400 minus log of 100 divided by log of 2, it means that is 0.301. So next one, log of 6400, it is equal to 3.81 minus log of 100, it is 2 divided by log of 2, means here 0.301. So after calculation, that N equal to 1.81 divided by 0.301. So it is equal to 6.01, and therefore that N or number of generations, it is equal to 6. Therefore number of generations, it is equal to 6. So this is, and we already find out in previous problem that it is dividing after every 30 minutes, and it when it divides for 3 hours, then the generations or number of generation will be 6. So here that is the same formula for the calculation of number of generations. So here we have calculated this number of generations. So here we finish this third problem. Now we will see, or we will move towards that fourth problem. So let's start that fourth problem. So now we will see the fourth numerical problem, and the problem is, if in 8 hours an exponentially growing cell population increases from 5 into 10 raised to the power 6 cells per ml, to 5 into 10 raised to the power 8 cells per mm. Calculate G, N, V and K. So these four parameters we have to calculate here, and we are having the information of, that is, initial population of cells, which is nothing but the N0, and it is 5 into 10 raised to the power 6 cells per ml, and then we are having the final population of cells, that is N, and which is equal to 5 into 10 raised to the power 8 cells per ml. Now the duration, or the T, it is also given. That T, it is nothing but the duration of exponential growth, and it is 8 hours. And we have to calculate that Z, which is called as generation time. Then we have to calculate small n, which is nothing but number of generations. Then we have to calculate V, that is division rate. And then we have to calculate K, that is called as specific growth rate or constant. So the first we will see here, that is calculation of number of generations. So here we are having formula for the calculation of number of generations, and that is equal to N equal to 3.3 multiplied by log of N, that is log of final population of cells, minus log of N0, that is log of initial population of cells. So actually in previous problem we have seen that here for the formula for calculation of number of generation, and that was equal to log of, that formula for the calculation of generation time, it was log of N minus log of, that log of N minus log of N0 divided by log of N0 divided by 0.301. We have that formula also here, that is Z equal to, or that is N equal to, or number of generations equal to. But when we further solve this, so we can, having this 1 divided by 0.301 into log of N minus log of N0. And when we solve this one, that is 1 divided by 0.301, then we will get this 3.3. And the remaining value is here log of N minus log of N0. That's why we can use this formula also here. That is number of generations, it is equal to 3.3 into log of N minus log of N0. Now we will put the values of this N and N0. So we will get 3.3 into log of 5 into 10 raised to the power 8 minus log of 5 into 10 raised to the power 6. So it will become 3.3 into 13.97. And final answer, that is N, it is equal to 46.10. So therefore the number of generation, it is equal to 46.10. So this is the answer of this first parameter, or that is number of generations. Now we will see the second point here, or second parameter, and that is G, or which is also called as generation time. So that we will see here, that G or generation time. So we are having the formula for generation time, and it is equal to G equal to T by N, or T divided by N. So here G equal to T divided by N means G equal to T means here time. So it is 8 hours, and N, which is we have calculated, that is 46.10. So g equal to t divided by n means g equal to 8 divided by 46.10 and which is equal to 0.17 hours. So this is our generation time. Therefore, generation time, that is g equal to 0.17 hours. So this is our generation time here, that is 0.17 hours. Now the next we will see here, that is V, or which is called as division rate. So that we will calculate here. Again we are having the simple formula for the calculation of division rate, and this division rate or that V, it is nothing but the reciprocal of generation time. So means that V equal to 1 divided by G. Now 1, we are having the value of now G, that is generation time, and it is 0.17. So therefore V equal to 1 divided by 0.17, that is equal to 5.88, that is hours, or it is nothing but the reciprocal of hour. Unit of that V is reciprocal of hour. So 5.88 h raised to the power minus 1 or per hour here. So this is the third parameter, that is division rate. And the fourth one is here, that we have to calculate specific growth rate. So specific formula for calculation of this specific growth rate, it is equal to, that is k equal to 0.301 divided by g. This is the formula for the calculation of this k or specific growth rate. And when we put these values here, so it will become 0.301 divided by 0.17. That g is nothing but the generation time. And final answer will become here 1.77. So this is the value of k here, that is specific growth rate, which is equal to 1.77. So in this way, we have seen that four numerical problems on generation time and bacterial growth. So definitely you will understand all these numerical problems here. If any doubt, you can comment in comment box, and don't forget to subscribe my channel, that is Microbiology by Santosh Nagde. Thank you very much.